video, motherfucker. Yeah, I work hard every motherfucking day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. But today is my day, it's my day. And no matter what they say, it's my day. La 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 la. Yeah. Roll up to the spot, feeling real good.
You spoke about your CrossFit family that you started CrossFit with.
Yes.
And how much of an impact it had to where you are now. So talk about that a little bit.
So I've always been someone who just kind of goes full into things. Mm-hmm. Like if I like something, I'll just commit to it. We talked about it last time. My first week I had to be told to leave. Like the owner of Matias was like, don't come back like tomorrow, like you gotta chill. And I had so many people there that just supported the hell out of me. They stayed late when I wasn't coaching, so I didn't like have a key or whatever. I'd have to like, you know, they'd coach for 4 hours and I'd be there like, please stay late with me, like let me work out more. And I had so many people like spend the late hours and spend time teaching me things and, you know, guiding me in like the right direction, challenging me, pushing me, you know, checking in with me. Like if, you know, there was a point where if like I did miss a day, you know, I was getting a text like, hey, like where you at? And I'm like, I'm tired. Because eventually I calmed down. But everyone there, just like, you know, you have families here, like, you know, in any CrossFit box, you have family. But there, it was like so many different types of love and support. I still get texts like checking in and like congrats on making regionals. I lived with, you know, a couple that were at the box, Bud and Scarlett. I lived with them for a while because I was like in the transition of like leaving Melbourne and coming to Orlando and like didn't really know like when it was happening or what to do. And like, I was just like, I don't know what I'm doing. They're like, just come live with us. And so they just like took me in, and they're like, one of their daughters, Kelsey, she's the best. She's a coach now at Omen over there. She's like grown so much. She always supported me, always was cheering me on, and just people there just love so easily over there. And
so talk about who supports you the most and how they inspire you and influence your daily life.
Well, there's a lot of things that I would say are in my support system. First and foremost, I have Alex. And, you know, it's hard, it's really hard for couples to be in the position where, you know, he's not only my training partner, he's my coach, he's my, you know, the person I live with, and it mixes a lot of stuff together, but it doesn't matter. I mean, when we're in the gym, like, he's coach, and, like, what he says goes. It doesn't matter how much I complain. Like, the other day, he was like, look, you can throw this fit all you want. Like, this is what the WOD is. And I was like, fine. He was just like, girlfriend Danny isn't going to get her way right now. And I was like, whatever. But it's amazing to have that, because he understands, you know, if I'm frustrated about something, he understands my frustrations, and he understands, like, that drive and that passion, and how just how shitty it can feel when you're not having a good day. And so he's my biggest supporter right now. He gets it. And he has helped me in so many ways. He's the one that's made me chase my weaknesses. I'd still just be snatching heavy in the corner if it weren't for Alex. So I owe him a lot. My parents have been amazing with everything. You know, coming out of college, you know, I had a plan. I was going to go to grad school, and I was going to do this and this, and I, like, just put it all on hold, put a, you know, pause, time out. I remember the phone call with my dad. I was like, so I think I'm going to do this, and, you know, he did the okay. You know, he did the research, and he, you know, he leaderboards more than I do, and he does more and more just reading online. He'll send me texts like, could you do this workout? And I'm like, yep. And, you know, we have those little conversations. He just checks in. He, like, doesn't have Instagram, but he'll, like, go online and, like, check out and be like, okay, well, that was a cool video, but, like, you need to be able to do this. And so he does things like that. My mom's just always, like, you know, my biggest cheerleader, like, always yelling from the stands. And then you got the support system that's, like, in the box. You know, I've got the nurse here, Larry and Miguel, that they push me in a way that's, like, still fun. They tease me and all that good stuff. But they support me so much, like, bending over backwards to help me in any way that they can. And I owe them a lot just a lot. I owe them so much. And you just got, you know, you got the members here that are always, like, you know, like you, like, hey, like, how's training going?
Yeah.
How's everything going? Are you ready? Like, are you feeling good? And all that stuff. And then I still got people from my old box that check in, and they're wondering how I'm doing and how training's going. And there's so many different levels of, like, the support system, and I feel so much love from all, like, facets. And then,
like, that's the community. It's not just, like, one type of person. It's people from all ages, all backgrounds, mm-hmm. all walks of life, and that's the greatest thing, I think, about CrossFit is the community.
Yeah, it's really funny how something that seems so, I don't even know how to describe it, but it just brings so many people together, and you don't find a lot of things that do that, that can interest, I guess, you know, hold and captivate so many different people.
Well, then you start talking to people, and you're like, oh, you know, I'm a doctor, I'm a lawyer, I'm a trainer, whatever it is, but...
The amount of times I get shocked from hearing what somebody does, I'm like, really? It still happens to me, I'm like, really?
And it's not like a condescending thing, like, but it's more like, you just don't know.
Fuck yeah.
We spoke about it before, the term leave your ego at the door goes farther than just thinking how good you are at CrossFit.
Yeah.
It's like one of those things where... You wear this, I think we spoke about it last time, you wear this hat all day, or like this, it's costume almost.
Mm-hmm.
And it's what you do for work. And then the perception of who you are, you know, whether, you know, like we said, a lawyer, doctor, CEO, engineer, artist, whatever. And then once you walk in the door, it's like you strip that costume off.
Yeah. I feel like people walk in, they just, like, they're like, you know, Superman. They're like, all right, I'm ready. They're like taking off their suit and they got on their cape now. And you know, you just have people that, you know, they're ready to, like, come dominate. And, like, they have no idea what CrossFit is. And they do their first WOD, and it just immediately humbles you. And, like, that's what I think really brings a lot of people together, is it's just, you can have, you know, for lack of a better word, like, power or control or being in a higher position in, you know, your regular day-to-day job or whatever, but you come in here, and no matter what the WOD is, like, you're probably going to get put on your ass. And it doesn't matter what you do day to day, but you're all going to come in here, and you're all going to end up on the floor by the end of that hour. And so, you know, you're not any, it just doesn't matter who you are.
Yep.
And it's awesome. It's totally awesome.
And you're challenged every day. Like, sometimes, you know, if I'm eating right, if I'm following a good diet, I'm coming on, like, you know, every other day, every day, I'm like, I'm feeling good, I'm doing good. And then one day, just smack in the face, and you're just like, bro, what is life? Like, why? Like, what is going on? I thought I was doing good, but that's the humbling factor, too.
Yeah.
And that's how you get better.
Yeah, for sure. Those ones, like, I mean, they frustrate everybody, and it's definitely, like, I had one this morning. It's just, you're not doing as well as you want to or as well as you expected. But those are the WODs that change you. Those are the WODs that make you better. The ones that you just want to, like, cry. You're like, you know, you just want to quit. Like, those are the ones you learn the most from. And you have to remind yourself of that sometimes. It's like, getting beat up is, like, you know, it's a good lesson sometimes.
I find it, it's almost like a full meditation.
Yeah,
you know?
Most intense meditation. It's therapy.
Is.
That's just what it is. It really is. When you have, like, a bad day and you can leave it behind for an hour, that's something I took away while I was, you know, when I coach, is a lot of times people have bad days at work. People have bad days with their family, with their husbands, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
And they come to CrossFit to de-stress. They come to therapy.
Yeah.
And so as a coach, like, it's your duty to give them the best hour of their day. That's what they need.
Yeah.
And that's what it is for me, coming to the gym. I mean, I live an awesome life, but gym time is really me time. It's time to focus on me. It's time to let it end. four walls of Subu. Like, it's just me and my workouts.
Yep.
So it is. It's totally just like, you can let everything go. And it's nice that people have that. Yep.
What are some of the obstacles that you've had to overcome? I know last time you said pride.
Pride was a big one. I just had like a natural knack at like being good at things. Having a gymnastics background made me primed for a lot of different sports, just, you know, body awareness. So like I just picked things up pretty quickly. So to just constantly kind of, you know, get in the sense like false security that, you know, things will always like come naturally type of thing. Well, CrossFit isn't like that. You can be good at some things, but there's going to be things you're bad at. You definitely have to put pride aside to, you know, work on them. You have to be bad at stuff for a while before you get good at it. So I did have to like push that aside and just realize that I'm not going to win every one, and I have to get over that. So that was definitely one of the big ones. And another big one was like the negative self-talk. It's something I'm still working on, but I had a problem with it for a while. I'm still kind of, you know, doubt myself in a lot of areas, and I get scared of WODs and start like, you know, worst case scenario, and then, you know, I don't do great on a workout, and then I immediately start thinking about regionals. I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna let everybody down. And so I just had to like let that go and just realize that like it's gonna go how it's gonna go, and I just gotta go out and give my best. The little voice in your head can either, you know, make you or break you in a way. It can either drive you to do better, or it can just tear you down so much that you really do just kind of implode. And when no one else is there, like when you have to do training sessions by yourself, or when you're on the competition floor and you don't have someone like right there screaming in your ear, it's going to be that little voice that you talk to and you hear during a really hard WOD. So I've had to realize that I want struggling.
What's some advice that you would give people that are currently struggling with health and fitness?
I think we kind of discussed this, but it has to be just like this internal want and drive. And I know that's like not what a lot of people want to hear. It's not like a magic pill where, you know, someone says something and all of a sudden it's the golden ticket. When you want to change your health and your lifestyle and your fitness, it has to be something that you want to do. I mean, people can encourage you and people can tell you things that will help you get there. They can help program for you. They can help you with your nutrition. They can guide you down paths. But until you are ready to accept the challenge of changing yourself and committing to it, it's really like you're changing yourself. No one's going to do it for you. For someone like me who's kind of surrounded every aspect of my life with CrossFit, I do personal training and I do remote programming. I do nutrition programming and coaching. I come here and coach. I train, you know, myself and get ready for my own competitions. So to have that be like my job, my life, my lifestyle, everything, like it is. It's my life. I'm surrounded by it 24/7. There's not a day that goes by that I don't, you know, work out for myself, or I don't program for somebody else, or I don't get texts or emails or calls about, you know, what their program means, or if they can see new videos, things like that. So it is. It's a full-time job.
Yeah.
It's every day.
And that's great because you love it. You're doing something that you truly love.
I don't work a day in my life. I really don't. And I know that's like, I guess, like cliche to say a lot of people, you know, there's that quote that, you know, you love what you do, you don't work a day in your life. But it was amazing the day that I kind of, like, that hit me really hard. That even though on the days where I feel like super stressed or super busy, like,